It speaks to, and I feel like a lot of this comes out of like this wave of organizing that's been happening around the country, and in particular, of course, like I think the elephant in the room for a lot of us is AOC winning and taking on Joe Crowley, and she represents actually Chaya's district.
How important do you think at this point the South Asian American civic engagement is? And when you are looking at your work at Chaya, especially in Queens, especially in New York, how important now do you think that voice is going to be for you and other South Asians?
So I think it's a really important time in our community to get engaged. I think tonight we talked a lot about what the political atmosphere is in this country, and that we're not going to get the services that we deserve unless we ask for it, right? And I think our community is mature enough now that we can play more of an active role and be civically engaged and run for office and hold elected office and work for elected officials, because this is our home and we have a state in how this, you know, how our city is going to look like, how our state's going to look like, and how our country is going to look like, right? So it's up to us to make that difference.
You know, while I have you, I have to ask you a few questions about Chaya. There's a lot of work they do on the grassroots levels, really helping out the immigrant community that may not have the same benefits as we often associate the immigrant community with, especially the South Asian diaspora. What could you tell our viewers about the current status of that population that you are working with? And how do you wish our community, you know, on the other side could help out?
The ones that are really wealthy, and then our constituency for Chaya, which is, you know, working class folks who are the, you know, taxi cab drivers, wait staff, or people who've just come over to the country and are depending on one income, which, as you can imagine, in this city is very hard to do. And so I think what the wealthier facet of our community can do is support groups like Chaya, or support groups like Saki, to help give them the resources so we could build a stronger community. Because at the end of the day, we're all here together. And it's like, what kind of New York City do you want to live in? Not everybody's been given the same opportunities that we've all been given. So what's the best thing you can do to help?
I had an interesting experience this year as mayor that a group, Tamil Heritage Group, emailed me and said, can you do a proclamation for our holiday of Pongal? And so I was, you know, more than happy to do that. I did a resolution honoring their holiday, and they came in and spoke a little bit about it. And someone said, well, how come no one, they had never approached anyone before? And I said, well, they might feel more comfortable because they know that at least I would have some familiarity with it, and I wouldn't be like, what is this?
You can pronounce it.
Yes, and so, you know, and in January, I had an intercultural holiday party, and any group that wanted to have a booth or bring food in or whatever did. And it was amazing how diverse it was. We have a Chinese school in our town. We have a Hindi school in our town. The Tamil group came in. We had a Persian group. So, and I think a lot of people in our town were just surprised that there was this diversity and there were holidays they'd never heard of. But you kind of have to open that door. And that's why representation is so important.
How gratifying has this been, and how much responsibility do you feel that you have when it comes to your faith as well as your ethnic background? Because those two are very huge together.
Sure. Well, I try to go to as many events as I can. I try to mentor people if I can. I try to make that time because I know that I try to be what I needed, what I have needed in my life, which is always examples that I could follow, some mentorship, because we don't always come in with the same understandings of different systems, especially as recent immigrant communities. So I just try to be that person that someone might need to help them get on their way.
Just talking about being that person, I would love to ask you a little bit of insight into your agenda for this season and maybe for this year. What is that the Montgomery, you know, area is going to look forward to when it comes under, you know, your as a mayor? And also, you know, is there anything particular that you're trying to cater to when you are working and really bringing forth the South Asian sentiments?
Right. Well, my platform this year has been to focus on transparency. So I've had town hall meetings about major projects in our town that wasn't being done. I've appointed members of the public to the Budget and Finance Committee, which we heard about, participatory budgeting. I've had a focus on communication. So I've established a committee to look into their communications and making sure that people are getting their information. They know how to communicate with us. And then my third platform has been diversity and inclusion. So we had things like our planning board didn't have a single woman on it. And so I have noticed those things and trying to bring in those different voices, because if your government isn't made up of the same makeup of your town, it's never going to represent their perspective.
Question to you is, you know, when you as Naveen Mehrotra from SKN attend these events, what is the key focus and what is the message from SKN that you're really trying to bring forth?
So for SKN, we want to make sure that our community understands that we do have health needs and we need to address them. We need to advocate for our needs, and we need to let our non-South Asian community know that there are many diseases that are specific to us, and just because we're considered, quote-unquote, the model minority does not mean that there are no needs for us. So we need to advocate at the level of the legislator. We need to let our physicians know. We need to let our healthcare system know that what our needs are, what our specific issues are. Diabetes is one of the biggest chronic diseases that we face as an Asian Indian. 20% of Indians have diabetes, and there are so many that just don't know. And it is our task to make sure that we learn how to take care of our illness appropriately and make sure that we have the best outcomes that we can. The other program that we run on special needs, and today being World Autism Day, it's great to be out here, is the Special Needs Community Outreach Program for Empowerment, where we bring families that have kids with special needs together so that they can support each other, that they can learn what their rights are, how can they access the best of services for their child through the school system. There's so many hours of services, the therapies that we are entitled to, but we just don't speak about it. We have to embrace our kids the way they are, and we have to advocate for them, and that is the only way that we will have the best for our community, and that's what SKN is about. So when we come out to these events, and we are joined with these esteemed panelists that are there that bring in different aspects of need for our community. So there's people here from Sakhi, which talk about domestic violence, our mayor, Sadaf, that's here. We have somebody talking about just poor housing in our community. So we are bringing the health agenda to the table, and that's what SKN is all about.